Welcome to Tech Zilla Bytes, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and we have a great question from Paul, who tweets, at Patrick Norton, just got a 3 terabyte hard disk drive, so time to upgrade my 8,000 plus audio files. What's the best, a super or high lossless bitrate or 192 kbps in iTunes? Great question. What we're talking about here is storage space versus sound quality. One quick thought, whatever you do, don't try to turn your current 8,000 song collection of 128K MP3s or 160K AACs into, say, 192K AACs or FLAC files. It sounds awful. It's just, you don't render things up. It doesn't work. And that's one of the reasons I chose to rip and encode my CD collection in a lossless format called FLAC. FLAC, AKA the free lossless audio codec, is my favorite. Though, if you live La Vida iTunes and iOS and iPods and iPads, you should go with ALAC, the Apple Lossless Audio Codec, which pretty much sounds exactly the same, because lossless means the encoding accounts for every bit of data from the original file. You get all the original audio data from the audio files on the CD. It just takes up about half as much space. Now, lossless or lossy compression like MP3 or AAC throws away, approximates some of those bits of data so the files can be much smaller. How much smaller? The audio on a CD takes up 10 megabytes per minute of music. You can fit 100 minutes of audio in 1 gigabyte of storage. That same gigabyte of hard drive space will fit over 20 hours of 128K MP3s. They'll sound awful, but you'll have a lot of tunes in that MP3 player you get picked up back in 2003 that has 1 gigabyte of space. Upping the encoding rate to 256K MP3 or 192K AAC, because those should sound approximately the same, you're looking at 10 to 13 hours in your gigabyte of storage, roughly 2 megabytes per minute of audio, and it's going to sound really good. The lossless files I love so much, around 4 megabytes per minute of audio. So that gigabyte of storage is 3 to 4 hours of audio. Are my lossless files a waste of space? Probably. A lot of folks have spent a lot of time doing blind A-B testing to prove that 192K MP3 is indistinguishable from the original CD audio. 256K AACs are the equivalent to 320K MP3s, and on and on. And frankly, lossless audio files are probably silly for most users, but I figure, hey, storage is cheap, I want all the musical bits I paid for, and I can re-render my lossless files on the fly into any other format I choose when I load my phone or tablet if I want to triple the number of audio files I take on a road trip. I'm also an audio geek, I got a dozen plus terabytes of storage on tap, and I pretty much built a 6 CD DVD Blu-ray drive machine so I could re-rip my massive CD collection in a couple of days. I'm probably kind of on the fringe side of the music nerd land. So, Paul and anybody else watching, I suggest you pick 5 songs you really know or think you know, encode them in various formats. All 5 of them, say from 192K MP3 and AAC files, 256K, 320K, right up to FLAC or AAC, and frankly, Apple Lossless and FLAC and the original CD should sound exactly the same. Then spend some quality time listening on a good set of headphones or with a well set up stereo system and decide for yourself. Feeling educated on audio? If you're looking to learn more about Linux or programming, or well, any of a couple of 1,000 different subjects, check out our sponsor, lynda.com/techzilla. Get yourself a free week of learning online via video you can access anytime, any place, at your own pace. It's good stuff, lynda.com/techzilla. By the way, you don't need a special machine to re-rip your CD collection. You can set up iTunes to rip Apple lossless and eject the CD when you're done. Then you can put that CD away and drop a fresh one in and close the drive. You do this every time you walk by the machine, and you'll work through a few hundred CDs in a couple of months. But having a bunch of CD drives attached to one computer will speed it up in a big way. I wanted to plow through my 900 plus CD collection as fast as possible, so I built the Rip Monster 3000. It can rip and encode 60 CDs an hour, at least if you sit around and replace the CDs as fast as the drives can read them. It's a lot like playing Tapper. I prefer an app called DB PowerAmp to iTunes for ripping and encoding. It's a super awesome app for encoding audio. I paid a little bit extra for DB PowerAmp's reference version because it comes with the Batch Ripper, which makes simultaneously ripping and encoding audio from a half a dozen CD drives go as smooth as possible. Matter of fact, it'll even run a robotic CD drive, which is super 21st century, but I don't have one. Those files I rip in DB PowerAmp, they're gonna sound as good as the original CDs. If you're a vinyl geek that can't stand CDs or digital audio, just comment down below or tweet at TechZilla and tell us why we all need to go out and buy record players and 182-gram vinyl audiophile pressings. Heck, if you think you got a better system for Paul to use to encode his 8,000 audio files, do us a favor and email TechZilla@revision3. Meanwhile, if you're looking for an affordable pair of audiophile-grade headphones, check out our review of Grado's latest SR60E. They sound amazing. Crazy good sound for under 75 bucks. With one big caveat, but you gotta watch the video to find out. Please subscribe to TechZilla Bytes at TechZilla.com or YouTube.com/TechZilla so you can get all of our product reviews, tips, tricks, and news. I'm Patrick Norton. Thank you so much for watching this episode of TechZilla.